Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're ready to all go on the raft back. I did buy 4 torches down in the Thieves Guild. They have underneath the tavern there. They have an unlimited amount. They also have that Thieves test, the Rogues test or Thieves test, whatever they're calling it. I do want to run through that, but I want to get her higher first, if that makes any sense. I don't know what it entails, but maybe we have to be really good at finding traps, disarming traps, lockpicking, searching maybe even, that kind of thing. So I don't know. So we'll tackle that another time. But for now, here we will take damage. There's gotta be a better way. So if they get in the water next to it. Okay, hold on 1 second. I consider this fair game. This is more of the interface than anything else. So if we go forward, forward. Okay, we are not hurt at this point. Okay. Navigating the waters here. That's cool, you can kind of see the outline there. We can go further. No, it ends here. Okay, we are undamaged. I consider that a win. Where the hell are we? We have interesting trees. And then the only thing around here is this cave. Now, I'm gonna drag the map over. We're looking here. Here's Burnville. We are here. So, I'm assuming we have to go in this mouth cave, or this cave, and then come out this cave mouth, and then Burnville. And then this is the Luminor's Tower here. I'm not sure. How we get there. Maybe things will be made clear to us at some point. Or maybe we won't be going there just yet. Maybe we'll be going across to another tower. Term is tower, I'm guessing. Unless there's some way through the mountains. But it really didn't look like we could go any further in the raft here. Though here, it looks like we can. Because then you could say we could go all the way around. And if we could get through here, then we could go in through here with the raft. I'm not sure. But anyway, that's what we're dealing with. So Burnville Tunnel. I am going to keep using this lantern here. I used it another 2 or 3 times. I think I've used it like 5 times already. I'm assuming it goes poof eventually. Oh, hello. Okay, we've got a singular orc here. Oh, I didn't. I gotta get the marching order back. I mean, these two are fine here. Attacking Nelvin. Hello, fiend. I would have words with thee. Can he use? Oh, he's got his sickle. Okay, awesome. No! The firebrand was broken. Nope. Unacceptable. Sorry, guys. We didn't get far, though. Okay, well, now we can change our order here. I kind of like them on either end like that. Okay. Once more into the fray. Okay, now we could just advance with impunity here. He did 1 point of damage. He's hitting Nelvin, that's not cool. And I'm not having her attack. We used the last of his ammunition, speaking of which, because she doesn't have any arrows left at this point. And I forgot to look for some, but I'm pretty sure they're not selling it. I forgot to look in the Alchemist Tower, to tell you the truth, for arrows. But I'm pretty sure they're not selling any in the general store in Spannenberg or the Thieves Guild, Rogues Guild, what have you. I didn't have to do that. He dropped a weapon. Yeah, these guys still takes a little while to defeat them. No retreat. Ride or die. Okay, 20 experience. I'll take the golden rations and the ironclad leather. We'll leave this stuff. Thank you. Alright. When you enter the tunnel, you immediately notice that the floor is covered in heaps of dirt and rubbish, a sure sign that orcs are around. Well, also the fact that one attacked us, that would also be a dead giveaway, pretty much. Alright. There's another friend. The monster eye glares threateningly. Attack! Two orcs. I'll take this one. You take that one. And what do we like? Rockfall? Which monster shall be your target? Mudsling. It's a single target. Earth slide. Which row of monsters? Here you go. Bulk. Ow. Eight and nine. Let me take one more time for that. Gotta save some for the next battle. 15 and 9. Poof! One down. Melvin's getting beat up here. Too late to retreat now, buddy. A lot easier with the magic. Okay, this is a separate room. Let's take a look at the map. We have to map out the north, which I'm thinking this is the north here. So, I'm guessing we're not going to find anything of use. I thought I turned around. Yeah, I meant to turn around to there. So that's the way out. Alright, and then there's that, and then dead end? Oh, monster. On the other side of the wall, I'm guessing? Or just hiding it around the corner here? is mapping out everything. So the tunnel... At the end of this tunnel, there should be something that requires a key. And luckily for us, we have that key. Burnville key. Found that in Father Anthony's chest. Monstre! Hello! Oh, there's a lot. Wait till they line up. And then I'll hit them with three rock falls or whatever it's called. Oh, these guys are gonna stay over there? That stinks. Alright, so the melee fighters then will wear this down and I'll hit them... That one will hit them with Rock Fall. Or Earth Slide, rather, because Rock Fall is a single target. Maybe I'll use a magic points. Potion or two. Thirteen and ten. Bonk in the head. I cannot penetrate the magical aura. I'm glad for that. So just in case something breaks, I only do this during battle, because if you restore after you've picked something up or dropped something, the item's gone, because, long story short, the game records onto the disk, or in this case, the file, the hard disk file, the virtual hard disk, where the item locations are. So if the item location changes, and then you save a state, once you retrieve that state, it's going to be gone from both where it was, because you picked it up, and it's going to be gone from your own inventory, because it's saved on the disk. It's not... I don't know how else to explain it. It's not saved in memory, which... The memory is where the save state recovers. Okay, we're getting some damage here. They're going after Nelvin. That's not good. Oh my god! They're all hitting him. Well, they're not very happy with him. Okay, so we're gonna need better. What does she have? Cause she's not doing anything. Healing potion 4. 2. We need at least 3. So we got 4. He doesn't have any. He's got 2, so we need better than that. Can I give this to her? Okay. Because she will go fast, first of all. She's a quick little rogue. So, she might heal him before these guys go. And plus that saves him for... casting another spell. So in this case, yeah, Earth Slide. Much better. still throwing, they're using up the last of their ammunition. They dropped their sling, bonk. Ah, they're starting to retreat, which they can. This one will be able to get away, because his friend's covering for him here. Do they have anything else for him? I think I want to rest. Rather than using any magic potions, I'll save them, because after this battle, we should be able to just rest in this room. It looks like another singular room. This guy should be pretty weak. But then again, now they're no longer fleeing. Now they're all attacking. So you know what? Might have him take a minor spell points. I do want to conserve them. Spell points 4 and 5. I'd rather not. Healing potion. All healing. Points 3. Right. Attack that one. Yeah, he's got half his spell points back. They're all lined up nicely now. We need to hit him with that rock slide spell. Earth slide, rather. Boom. Clunk. One down. Two down. Love it. Nice, just one left. Look at that. Rockfall here. Boink. Yay! Nice! Nelvin, level 8. 49 total life points, 150 power points or magic points, 29 spell learning points. We need to be able to train these people. 69 training points. Eight rations, 340 gold. Pick up as many of these ironclad leather as we can. Look at the nice little picnic table they've got set up. Isn't that quaint? This looks like it is just one room. Alright, we will sleep and then head back into the thick of things. Just check. We got banged up. Make sure we got our stuff. Nothing broken. Good. Okay, what about rations? 14. We have... She's got 13. Wait, that... No, rations. I'm looking at the wrong thing. 52 rations. 3, 4, and 4. Hmm. Let's sort through it after. We need to rest again to get all his magic points back. And not gonna let us. Which is the stupidest decision ever. I mean, you know we have to rest to... heal up fully a lot of times. Actually, I should have moved more food off. Oh well. This item has no charges left. I don't know if we can recharge them. It might be possible to recharge them in a town. But I have so many others. You know what? I'll just hold on to it anyway. So I'm not sure. I think we used this about 8 times, I'm guessing. Wasn't really, you know, keeping track of it meticulously. And it gives us a lot longer time to do our thing, you know, before it runs out. So, continuing. Okay, is this where we use the key? Could be. The once fine wood carvings on this door have been almost destroyed. It looks as if someone had tried to break the door open with an axe, but in vain, apparently, because it is still firmly on its hinges. Is this what we use the key for? Citrina's unlocked the door. A horrible picture awaits you. Whole skeletons and bits of skeletons lie everywhere. Indeed. Does a skeleton have any loot? Apparently not. So people died down here. Trying to get to the other side? From Burnville, perhaps? Oh, what do we have here? Nothing. Someone was trying to get away. Let's just map this out so we can see everything on the map. A skull. Another skeleton. More bones. Has anything been snacking on these bones? Seems a bit foreboding. You're about to leave when you suddenly hear a loud roar. The face of a fire giant appears from a corridor. He snarls at you with fiery lips. Ah, some more food at last. I've had nothing sensible to eat for years. With these words, the Colossus moves out of the corridor and attacks you with his huge club. And there he is.